Shalom, everybody. Welcome back to breastlive.org. Insights in the Parsha of the Week, Parshat Bo, which is amazing because it's within the 40-day period now before Purim, which in Breastlive circles and teachings, they speak a lot about the significance, or they speak about the importance of these days, these 40-day period, as a preparation for the Purim experience. Because Purim, Rabbi Nachman, is a very, very big opening for helping a person really come closer to Hashem and to have major breakthroughs in life through Purim, Bezat Hashem. In any event, this week's Parsha Bo, we complete the final three of the 10 Makot, plagues inflicted in Egypt upon the Egyptians. And with those 10 Makot, the Jews then were able to leave Egypt, and eventually the story of the Red Sea, the splitting of the Red Sea, and then come, and then the desert, receiving the Torah, eventually leading to coming into Eretz Yisrael. Rav Nosson, he points out the significance of the 10 plagues and the number 10, which is not by chance. These 10 have a parallel throughout the Torah, the number 10. You have, for example, the 10 utterances with which Hashem created the world with. It's called Asar Mamarot Nivra Olam. It's in Pirkei Avot, Ethics of Our Fathers, chapter 6, that Hashem, with 10 utterances, created the world. That's what we find at the beginning of the Chumash in Genesis, Vayomer Elokim, and the Lord said, let there be light, etc. And we have also corresponding to that, as the Holy Zohar, the Tikkuni Zohar explains, the 10 Sfirot, the 10 channels of energy used by Hashem to send different channels of energy like Chesed, Gvura, Tiferet, etc. Okay? Then you have these 10 Makot, the 10 commandments that we receive the Torah, 10. And like Rabbi Nachman stresses and is brought down in the Gemara and the Zohar, the 10 types of song used by King David and other tzaddikim to write the book of Tehillim Psalms. And which Rabbi Nachman puts major, major emphasis on these 10 psalms, these 10 types of song, for helping a Jew to have a redemption. So Rav Nosson points out that the number 10, the total 10 culmination of the 10 Makot in Egypt, was in order to sever the attachment of the evil forces that had a stronghold over the Jews in Egypt and to let them be released. Because Rav Nachman explains that the 10 songs, their power is to combat and mitigate the evil force, the Klipa, who's known as Lamed Yud, Lamed Yud Tav. This feminine evil force is very strong in taking human energy and keeping it captive. So in a sense, what she does parallels the Egyptian bondage. They didn't let the Jews go. Enslaving them under the bondage of Egypt parallels what the Klipa does by taking the holy sparks of Jews. Specifically, Rabbi Nachman explains, and the Zohar explains, and the Gemara explains, by wasted seed, in other words, sexual blemishes, where this is unfortunately the big, big time, unfortunate place where a person causes captivity of holiness. What has to be done is to release it. Just like the releasing of the Jews from Egypt, we have to also release. So he says that the 10 plagues come to activate, to represent the activation of the 10 types of melody, which culminated with at the Shirat Hayam, when the Jews sang the song of leaving, the splitting of the Red Sea, going through the Red Sea and leaving Egypt, the Jews were able to finally sing. And the song of Shirat Hayam, Rav Nosson explains, is a culmination, believe it or not, of representing the song due to the 10 plagues which were inflicted in Egypt, which Rav Nosson explains correspond to Hashem, because the Jews didn't receive the Torah yet. There was no book of Tehillim yet for the Jewish people as a whole. It says that Yaakov Avinu said Tehillim, Avraham with Ruach HaKodesh, even before it was given by King David, they knew verses of Tehillim, they said Psalms of Tehillim, but to give it to the Jewish people as a national gift, that only can happen once the Jews receive the Torah at Har Sinai, receiving the 10 commandments that in them were hidden the 10 types of song, fine. But in the meantime, Hashem on his part had to send an activation of the 10 psalms, but in the format of 10 plagues, because that's what the 10 types of song do. They were able to release the holy sparks trapped in Egypt, which is the Jews, plus all the holy sparks they contained, with them. Like the Arizal teaches that all of the holy sparks, holy souls, which were emitted in vain by Adam, Adam Arishon, he was refraining to be with his wife Chava for 130 years. The birth of Shet took place only 130 years after the whole incident in the Garden of Eden and Cain and Hevel, etc. He abstained 130 years, and the Gemara says, and the Zohar says, that he was heated by this klipa called Lamed Yud Lamed Yud Tav to have wasted seed, and she took these souls. And the Arizal teaches they were reincarnated in Egypt, both as the Jews who lived in Egypt and also the converts, the Erev Rav, who came back, but they had to be released. So the releasing effect, he teaches, explains with Nosin, was through the 10 plagues, which symbolize the 10 types of song, which we today have to be able to release us also from our personal exile. Shabbat Shalom.